I think some of you already know, but I'm actually a real engineer here in Canada. I'm a software engineer, and I also have a master's in machine learning and AI. And one thing I learned while studying neural networks and different learning algorithms is that data is everything. That's why I love so much journaling. So in today's video, I'm going to show you every details of my journal, and I hope it can help you build your own dataset. So the trade that we will be reviewing today is this one on the 27th of September. So you can see that first it went to take out yesterday's high, then left a fair value gap on the 5 minutes that wasn't filled here, but there's this one that was filled. Then let's check on the 3 minutes. On the 3 minute, this one was successful. So you can see here this fair value gap that we filled and then went back down. On the 2 minute, similarly, the same thing, so fair value gap, the entry was right there, then we went back down, and then on the 1 minute. So some important information, we had the displacement of around 800, the execution was at 953, and the setup formed at 950. So now time to fill in the information. So first we start by the entry date. It was the 27th of September. The time, the instrument, you can have multiple if you're trading, for example, US 500 or different things. The type of setup, since I'm only trading one type of setup, I called it the classic one. In this case, it was a sale. Then you can put up the entry price, stop loss, take profit. This allows the system to consider and calculate some things like what was your profit target, how far it went in your direction and against your direction. The quantity, I don't really care about the quantity, is the number of lots. In my case, I don't really care about that. The exit date, usually it's the same day for me. At what time it was, the exit price, in this case it was a take profit, and then the profit of lot or loss, 2,500. Where this is important is the advanced trade data. So the trade comment, so let's first start here. The entry comments, I have multiples in this case. Usually when it's a good trade, or a trade following my rules actually, then a break of high low or lower high, and then a fair value gap. But especially at the beginning when I was still studying, I had multiple trades where there would be no stop hunt or even no break of higher low or lower high. I was still learning, I was trying different things, so I needed to add those things. Some examples I also showed in this YouTube is when a target is already taking out. If there's a trade before 9:30, I don't do that anymore, but at the beginning I used to trade even at 8:30. When the displacement is too weak, for example, if it's less than 600 or even, I used to take trades with a displacement of 200. So clearly this is way too weak. A tree drive, if you remember in the, I think the third episode of the ICT Mentorship, he explained an example where you would have three highs, for example, then getting to the same level as the previous high, and then going back down. I'm going to show you an example right there. A displacement, if it's too slow, so even if there's something like a 600 displacement, but it's too slow, this can happen during bank holiday, for example, or right around Christmas. So there's a fair value gap with a displacement, but the displacement is not very important and fast. Another example is when we have a gap, we fill this gap, and then we break a higher low or lower high, and then we have the fair value gap. And then the last one, I don't trade it too much, is let's, for example, on the 15 minute, we have a fill of fair value gap on the 15 minute with the order block, and then we have the setup forming. But in this case, it's simply a stop hunt, a higher low, lower high, and then fair value gap. The exit comment, it's either take profit, partial plus break even. At the beginning, I used to take partials, I tried different things, but currently I'm just going for a take profit or stop loss. If it was a break even, a stop loss, or if I manually closed it. But in this case, it was a take profit. The trade management. Like I explained, I used to try different things such as taking half of the profit at the first low, going break even, and taking the rest of the profit at the end of the day around 4 p.m. but currently I'm just going for the first obvious level. Then you can put how high the price went and how low it went, if the original take profit was hit. So for example, let's say you have your take profit at 3%, but you manually close your trade at 2.5. Then you would still say that it eventually went to the original take profit, but you took profit before. Here, if you want to put at break even. And then those are specific custom stats that I personally wrote. So the first one, you know it well if you've been following this channel. Was it on the 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute, 4 minute, or 5 minutes? In this case, the trade, as you could see, was forming all time frames. If you look here on the 5 minute, there was a setup right there with the first fair value gap and then the second fair value gap. And since it filled around the entry and we could see those fair value gap on the 5 minutes, I would consider this trade was valid on the 5 minute. Then the execution time. In this case, since the execution time was at 9:53, I would need to put 9:45 here, because I could not just write every single minute. So I just went with jumps of 15 minutes, and this worked well for me. So if we continue here, the displacement was of 850. So we come back here and then we just select everything below 800. The stop hunt level timeframe. So some people were asking me, why don't you just consider levels which are very significant? For example, on the 1 hour, 4 hour, 15 minutes, instead of using some 1 minute levels. So this is what I'm considering here. Since this trade, we could see clearly the yesterday's high on the 5 minute. This is the 15 minutes. And also on the 1 minute, then I need to write here 15 minutes, 5 minutes, and 1 minute. But if I could just see the level that was taking out on the 1 minute, I would just write the 1 minute. Here, this is the Fib entry. It can be below the 38. At the 38, if there is no stopping, so if no Fib levels were respected, and 50, 62, 78, and 88. I know ICT suggests to always take fair value gap which are above the 50, and I think he's using 62 and 79 instead of those levels, but this is around the same thing. I don't really use them too much, but if you want to measure it in this case, so in this case it almost went to the 61.8, so I will just write the 50. I didn't want to make a long 30 minute video, so I did two parts. On this next video, I will go over trends, 8:30 and midnight relations, and correlations between US 500 and timeframes.